Hello students, welcome back to your online classes. I hope you all are keeping well. I am your new GK teacher, Miss Krishanta. Students, today we will be starting with the topic brain teasers, okay? Page number 24, chapter 15. Answer the following questions. Number one, you will buy me to eat but never eat me. What am I? So in every question you have to use your brain, okay? You will buy me to eat but never eat me. What am I? So a plate, because you will buy but you cannot eat that plate, right? So answer is a plate. Number two, you can serve me but you cannot eat me. What am I? So answer for this riddle is a tennis ball or badminton. Okay, badminton shuttle. Okay, there will be shuttle also, badminton shuttle. Like you can serve this but you cannot eat this. Okay, number three, what can you catch but not throw? That means what you can catch but cannot throw, that is cold. Okay, cold means this is, you can catch cold but you cannot throw. Like cold is sickness, like cough and cold, no, that one you can catch cold but cannot throw. Number four, what goes up and down but never moves? Temperature. Sometimes it is high, sometimes low, but it doesn't move, okay? Five, I have hands but can't clap. Who am I? Answer is clock, because the clock has hands, three hands. Clock has three hands, okay? But it cannot clap. Six, what gets wetter and wetter the more it dries? That is towels. After taking bath, we dry our body with towels, no, but the towel gets wetter, so the answer is towel. 7. I have keys but no doors. I have space but no rooms. I allow you to enter but never able to leave. What am I? So answer is the keyboard, because this keyboard has no doors, okay? It has keys, but this keyboard has keys, no? So, but no doors. And this keyboard has the space key. And this keyboard has also the enter key. So, answer is the keyboard. 8. What is so delicate that saying its name breaks it? Silence. So, silence is the answer. Number 9. It has a neck but no head and wears a cap. What is it? Bottle. Okay, because bottle has a head. A bottle doesn't have head but it wears a cap. No, you can see the cap of a bottle. It also has a neck. Number 10. What never asks questions but is often answered? Doorbell. And it gives answers, no, when that doorbell gives the answer, but it doesn't ask questions. Next topic is renowned books and authors. Renowned means famous, okay? The famous books and the authors, famous authors. Match the following authors with their famous literary work. Literary means related to literature, okay? And here what you have to do is, you have to match the authors with their famous books. So, here are the, in one side, here are the names of authors, and in another side, here are the names of books. Which author has written which books, okay? You have to match this. Number 1, William Shakespeare, Julius Caesar, okay? Number 2, Mahatma Gandhi has written My Experiments with Truth. and Charles Dickens has written A Tale of Two Cities. And number 4, Guru Rabindranath Tagore has written Gitanjali. Number 5, Anita Desai has written A Village by the Sea. Number 6, Arundhati Roy has written The God of Small Things. Number 7, Alexander Dumas has written 3 Musketeers. Okay. Number 8, Sarojini Naidu has written The Broken Wing. Number 9, Leo Tolstoy has written War and Peace. Number 10, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam has written Wings of Fire. Next subtopic is books and books, plays and poems. Okay. Match the authors to their famous books. So here are the names of authors. Okay, authors, and you have to match the authors with their famous book. Okay, here also same thing, which author has written which famous book. Okay, you have to match this. Number 1, Vyasa has written which book? Mahabharata. Then number 2, Enid Blyton has written Famous Five. Then number 3, Hans Christian Andersen has written Ugly Duckling. Number 4, William Shakespeare has written Merchant of Venice. Number 5, Rudyard Kipling has written Jungle Book. Number 6, Sudha Murthy has written Grandma's Bag of Stories. Number 7, Herman Melville has written Moby Dick. Okay. And number 8, Lewis Carroll has written Alice in Wonderland. So the next topic is happiness. Okay. So in class 4 also you have already learned about this topic, happiness, right? So happiness is a person's happiness is the state of being happy. Okay, the state of being happy. So happiness is a state of mind, not a characteristic. So this happiness is a state of mind, means a person's emotions. Okay, state of mind means a person's emotion, not a characteristic. Means this happiness is a not a quality or characteristics. That means this happiness doesn't define a person's personality or quality. Okay, we can stay happy most of the time depending on the circumstances. So we can remain happy most of the time, but it depends on the situation. When we feel motivated, thankful, kind and confident, we are in a state of happiness. So when we will be happy? When we feel motivated, thankful, kind and confident, that time we will be in the state of happiness. Staying happy is not a difficult task. Okay, so to remain happy is not a difficult thing. Okay, happiness needs to be built up by doing positive things. So in order to build happiness, what you have to do? You have to think positive things. Okay, right kind of attitude and habits, obeying our elders, eating healthy, and a little discipline brings a lot of happiness. So what brings a lot of happiness? When you show your right kind of attitude and habits to others, and when you obey your elders, and when you eat healthy food, and when you discipline yourselves, that brings a lot of happiness. So here are some exercises. Let's do it. Given below are a pair of statements. T Take the one which you agree with. And here are pair of statements, okay? So you have to choose which one do you agree, which one do you feel that this one is the right answer. So you have to tick, you have to mark, okay? You have to tick that answer. Number one A, worrying about something is bad. 1B, worrying is okay, but too much worrying about something is not good. So which one do you feel that is okay? You tick, okay? So number two, I have ticked here. Sorry, number one B, I marked this one, okay? 2A, negative thoughts do not harm us, they prepare us for success. And 2B, negative thoughts harm us and we must learn to stay positive. So here I marked number 2A, okay? Number 3A, I am not afraid of anything in life. 3B, I am afraid of many things in life, but I must learn to face my fear and understand it. So here I marked 3B. 4A, if I have any doubts, I cannot do anything important in my life. 4B, I must begin even when I have doubts. The doubts should not discourage me. So here I have marked 4B, okay? 5A, I can stay happy and healthy even with the negative thoughts in mind. 5B, I can stay happy and healthy as I allow the negative thoughts to pass and do not linger on them. So here I marked 5B. 6A, I must ignore negative thoughts and should never tell anyone about them. 6B, I must analyze the negative thoughts and discuss with elders. Here I marked 6B. 7A, showing kindness to others and helping others makes us emotionally weak. 7B, showing kindness to others and helping others makes us emotionally strong and a better person. So here I marked 7B. 8A, having negative thoughts and feelings means I am not a normal human being. 8B, having negative thoughts and feeling means I am a normal human being. So here I marked 8B, okay? So which one do you think that this one is right or I agree with it? You have to tick that answer, okay? Count option A and B. So here what you have to do is you have to count in which option it is marked more, okay? A higher score for option B is an indicator of readiness to be happy. So if you have marked more in option B, so that means that you are ready to be happy, okay? You can take this test again after some time, and after some time again you can take this test, okay? You can try it again. So next is same topic only. Gratitude brings happiness. So gratitude means thankful, okay? When we are thankful to others, when we are thankful to others, that time only we can be happy, okay? We have to be grateful or thankful to others. Then only it gives us happiness. Acknowledging someone's favor, being thankful for our blessings from Almighty, and expressing our gratitude to people for what they do for us is one of the important factors to ensure happiness. So what gives us happiness? When we realize that someone has helped us, and when we will be thankful for the blessings which we have received from God, and when we show our thankfulness to people for what they have done to us, then only it brings us happiness, okay? We have to realize all these things. Gratitude spreads harmony and helps you make good friends. So when you are grateful to others, when you are thankful to others, what happens? You can live together peacefully, okay? Harmony means you can live together peacefully, and you can also make good friends, okay? Being thankful to others develops our character and personality. And when we are thankful to others, what happens? It builds our character as well as our personality, okay? Prepare a weekly gratitude journal to record the acknowledgments for what other people have done to help you in different ways. So here it is given, so like this journal, you have to prepare a weekly journal where you have to thank the people for what they have done to you, okay? And you have to write in the journal. Below is the format of the journal which you can use to have a collection of your thank yous to others. So here you can see the format of journal. Here you can write to whom you have to say thank you and for what you have to write here, okay? This journal will help you reflect and focus on all the good things that happened to you in past days. And when you write in the journal what happens, this will help you to reflect and focus on all the good things that you have done in the past days, okay? This will increase your joy, make you emotionally strong, and if you read it before going to bed, you will have a quality sleep. Go ahead. That means when you write in this journal, what happens? It will increase your joy. That means you will be happy, and emotionally also you will be strong. And before going to bed, if you read this journal, what happens? You will have a sound or peaceful sleep. Okay. So this is the format of the journal, my gratitude journal. Month and year, okay? So here, start date, which date you have to write, month and which year. I'm grateful to whom? To your father, mother, it can be anyone, okay? And for what reason you have to write. So you have to fill this one also. So next is compute matrix. Read the clues and complete the crossword. So here are the crossword puzzles. So we have to, and clues are also given, and we have to complete it, okay? And these crossword puzzles are related to the computer words, okay? Number one, a set of sheets in an electronic spreadsheet program that is called workbook. Number one is workbook. Number two, source options for the selected tab in the program that is called ribbon. Okay, number two is ribbon. Number three, a set of rows and columns to store data where you can store. There are a set of rows and columns where you can store data is called worksheet. Okay, number three is worksheet. Number four, page orientation in which height is less than width. Height is less than width. That is called landscape. Okay, landscape. And number five, first calculating devices invented about 5,000 years ago in China. That is called abacus. Abacus. Okay. Number six, DAS replaced vacuum tubes in second generation of computers. That is transistors, okay? Transistors replaced vacuum tubes in second generation of computers. Number eight, technology to exchange messages and attachments online, that is email. From email we can send messages and attachments, okay, online. Number nine, combining two or more cells in a table into one, that is called merge, okay? That is called merge. 10. Any action that occurs any time due to user interaction such as mouse click, that is called event. And the next is match the following. So here in this side you can see the pictures. Over here are the pictures, okay? So you have to match these pictures with these names, okay? Here are the names of these pictures, so you have to match these both, okay? So number one is remote control. Number one is the picture of remote control. And number two, cordless phone, okay? And number three, AI operated smart speakers. Number four, camera. Number five, USB pen drive. And number six, smart watch. Number seven, tablet. And number eight is the picture of hover boat, okay? Hover boat. And next topic is our space. India has really done an excellent job in the field of space exploration. Dr. Vikram Sarabhai is considered as the father of the Indian space. So, Dr. Vikram is called as the father of the Indian space. So, number A, choose the correct answer. Number one, India's unmanned satellite to orbit around the moon. So, here you have to choose the right answer. Number A, Chandrayaan 1, IRS-1A, INSAT-1D. So, which one is the right answer? Chandrayaan 1, okay? Number two, what is the name of the rocket that carried Apollo 11 into space? Number A, Saturn 5, Titan 23G, Ariane 5. So which one? Saturn 5. Number 3, what do you mean by solar eclipse? Options are given here. Number A, the moon comes between the sun and the earth and blocks the sunlight from reaching the earth. Number B, the earth comes between the sun and the moon and blocks the sunlight from reaching the moon. Number C, none of these. So, which one is the answer? Number A. The moon comes between the sun and the earth and blocks the sunlight from reaching the earth. Number 4. She died on a space mission in Space Shuttle, Columbia. Who is this great Indian astronaut? Option is Sunita Williams, Kalpana Chawla, Jerry Cobb. So, answer is Kalpana Chawla. Number 5. Which of the following planets does not have any satellite? Earth, Jupiter, Mercury. So the answer is Mercury. Number B, name the following honorable personalities. So here are the pictures of those honorable persons. Okay, so number one is Rakesh Sharma and number two, Vikram Sarabhai. As I already told you that Dr. Vikram Sarabhai is the father of the Indian space, okay? And Kalpana Chawla. And the fourth one is Sunita Williams, okay? So this much for today. And students, whatever I taught you till now, you have to write all the answers, okay, in your book. And these answers I will send you in WhatsApp. Thank you.